Praise the Lord, brethren, in the most precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I yesterday had a vision of the night that I thought it wise to share it with us. I want to believe that what the Lord revealed to me is going to help some people. So I decided to make this video to share it with us. I went to sleep yesterday meditating on Proverbs chapter 31. So I read the book of Proverbs chapter 31 and I was meditating on Proverbs chapter 31 before going to bed. But I remembered why on the Tuesday fellowship I went to the Lord and I was asking the Lord to examine me and reveal to me if there be any issue that is God against me. So I went for a divine checkup. So I shared a message on Tuesday talking about divine checkup. That it is good. How often do we go to the hospital in the physical to check ourselves to see if we are doing okay, if we are well? So it is the same thing. We also need to go to the Lord to ask the Lord to reveal to us the state of our health or our walk with Him per time. So we really need to do that often. So it was like a divine checkup. So I was praying and I was asking the Holy Ghost. That was the topic of our Tuesday fellowship. That Lord, examine me and reveal to me anything that you have against me. Like we studied the book of Revelation, and in the first book of Revelation, Revelation chapter 2, chapter 3, the Lord was writing the letter to the seven churches, and among all those seven churches, He enumerated the good things that they were doing that was okay. Thank God for the reward, but all of them, they had a nevertheless. He said, nevertheless, these things I have against you. How often we concentrate on the ones that we are doing that are already okay. That one, we already have a reward for that. We don't need to bother about those ones. But what about the ones that we are not doing right? How often do we go to ask the Lord to reveal to us? But also, when you go to the Lord will tell you if there be a nevertheless in your life that He wants you to repent from, He will reveal to you. The Holy Ghost is the revealer of the secret. He is the greatest teacher that you can ever want Him to teach you, and when you go to Him, He is going to reveal some things to you. So I went to sleep yesterday night. I was praying and meditating on Proverbs chapter 31. I was praying the prayer of the virtuous woman, and I was praying scripture after scripture and asking the Lord to make me like the woman of Proverbs chapter 31. So while I was doing those prayers, I wouldn't say it is dream, because I saw my bed clock when it was 11:58 p.m. So I knew that at that time I started praying in tongues. After I finished praying Proverbs chapter 31 scripture after scripture, I continued praying in tongues. And while I continued praying in tongues, I fell into this vision. And while in the vision, I heard a voice that said, "You have asked me questions. I will give you the answers." And immediately I could recognize the voice. I knew that indeed this is the voice of the Lord. So immediately in that revelation, the revelation was in the setting of a house. I immediately fell down on my knees and I lifted up my two hands to heaven with my head raised up. And I said, "Speak, Lord, for thy servant heareth." So I knew that the voice was the voice of the Lord. I saw nobody, but I heard the voice, and the voice was coming from my right. So I fell down on my knees with my two hands lifted up. I said, "Speak, Lord, for thy servant hear it." And the voice went ahead. It said some things, and why I said that, "Speak, Lord, for thy servant listen it," I started pleading with the Holy Ghost. I said, "Holy Spirit, please help me. Help me to remember everything that the Lord would tell me when I wake up so that I will be able to write it." So right in that trance, I knew it was the Lord speaking. And I was thinking that maybe I may forget some important issues. So I was pleading with the Holy Spirit. I said, "Holy Spirit, please help me to remember everything when I woke up from this revelation so that I should be able to write them and understand them the way the Lord wants me to understand." You know, the Bible says that my sheep hear my voice and they obey me, and the voice of a stranger they will not hear. When I heard that voice, I immediately knew that this is the voice of the Lord. So I humbled myself before Him. I went down on my knees with my two hands lifted up, and I said, "Speak, Lord, for thy servant listeneth." And the voice went ahead. The voice said some things, but when I woke up from the revelation, these are the only things I remembered. So I remember the one that says, "Speak, Lord, for thy servant listeneth." And the Lord said that, "You have asked questions, I'm going to answer." I say, "Speak, Lord." And the voice said this to me. It says, "Look not unto your teachers, but look unto me." That is what the Lord said. He said, "Look not unto your teachers, but look unto me." So when I woke up from that revelation, I immediately grabbed my book and I remembered that one. The voice said that, "You have asked questions, I will answer you." And when he spoke, he said to me, "Look not unto your teachers, but look unto me." Then when I woke up, I immediately understood, because remember, I told you on Tuesday, the prayer topic was, the topic of our message was a divine checkup. Going to the Lord to ask the Lord to reveal to us our state. Paul says, "Examine yourself to see if you be in the faith." And the psalmist says, "Try me, O Lord, and if there be any wicked, may we remove it." The Lord said in the book of Revelation to the seven churches, he said, "Nevertheless, these things I have against you. Repent, because I'm coming shortly." So there are some issues you maybe need to repent from. But if you don't go to the Lord to ask the questions, you might not know. Dear brothers and sisters, we need a divine checkup in our life as we can go to the physical hospitals. In the theater, the hospital of the Holy Spirit is the lab technician. When you go there for a divine checkup, if there be any issues, he will reveal it to you. So this is the voice. The voice said that, "Look not unto your teachers, but look unto me." And I knew that this was the voice of the Lord speaking. Hallelujah. So I will continue with the interpretation of this dream.